I think co-working has created the most amazing impact on startups, because just imagine when we used to start up, in my first startup, I spent almost 35% of my seed capital going out there, giving in a security deposit to the landlord, giving in fees to an architecture firm, then building my office. And I realized one thing, that for startups, the team goes through crests and troughs very, very quickly. We have expansion, we have contraction, and we have long-term leases. Just imagine I paid a 9-year lease. I don't need to do that with an innovator or a co-working operator. What you need to do is just go plug and play. You have an opportunity to take a 1-hour meeting room to a 9-year lease, whatever you want. The idea is, why do we need to give commitment upfront without capital investing? You convert all your capital expenditures into operating expenditures. And that at our focus is, you focus only on your product. Do not give capital into capex, into furniture, which is a depreciating asset. And this also provides us a massive opportunity to actually tap the startup ecosystem. As we speak, we have a pass called the Flexi Pass. Across India, you can access any innovate at a starting price of 2999. तो मतलब 2999 में तो आजकल सीसीडी स्टारबक्स की कॉफी कब वो नहीं आता, और जब भी आप अंदर जाओ आपकी कॉफी खत्म होती है तो बारटेंडर आपकी तरफ से देखता है कि यार कब निकलेगा ये. द आइडिया इज हैव योर ओन स्पेस, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. I think huge innovations. Ye to abhi tak we have not even scratched the surface of the industry. We are not even at 1 or 1.2% of the entire office uptake. I think eventually, this is my personal guess, this is not innovator or any or OYO speaking, this will be at least 90% by 2040, because this makes sense. People are, and we have large companies like BBC, we have companies like RBL Bank, jo kabhi baat bhi nahi karte the co-working, everyone has started adopting co-working because it makes business sense. Every large company, Fortune 500 company, has realized that they need to be agile, they need to be thinking like a startup, and they need to make sure they do not have large assets which are depreciating on their balance sheets. मैं तो हमेशा कहता हूँ कंपटीशन है ही नहीं. वी हैव जस्ट 450 प्लेयर्स. होटल में देखो कितने वो है, और अभी भी दिन प्रतिदिन नए नए होटल ब्रांच खुलते हैं. द आइडिया इज दिस इज, एंड द गुड पार्ट इज, जितने प्लेयर्स खुलेंगे, एंड दिस इज द ओनली इंडस्ट्री विच इज ट्रूली कोलैबोरेटिव इंडस्ट्री. वी हैव अ व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप ऑफ ऑल द फाउंडर्स टुगेदर, एंड वी मेक श्योर दैट वी मीट वेरी फ्रीक्वेंटली, बिकॉज वी आर द टॉर्च बेयरर्स ऑफ दिस इंडस्ट्री. एंड ये 450 ऑपरेटर्स में से सिर्फ 13 या 14 जिनके पास 2 से ज्यादा कोवर्किंग सेंटर्स हैं. इफ वी ऑल कम टुगेदर, द मोर सेंटर्स इज दैट स्टार्ट, each and every one of them is educating everyone about co-working. पहले है ना 2015 में जब हम चालू किए थे, no one even thought कि co-working होता क्या है. आज everyone knows कि co-working नाम की का एक चीज है. But 2025 you will see massive adoption by large old corporations of India, and even SMEs will start happening to co-working. So my only advice is, be frugal. Do not understand the market. And do not spend money unnecessarily. Be as frugal as possible. Be mindful and leverage technology. This is not a real estate game alone. This is community led, technology led, and make sure this makes business sense. बहुत बार होता क्या है, entrepreneurs they enter, create amazingly lavish spaces, but there are no takers. 20-25,000 per seat कोई नहीं लेगा हिंदुस्तान के अंदर. India is a 999 market. I would say it's a 699 market, जहाँ पे this is the base of the pyramid, and there the demand is infinite.